Welcome to NewsStand. NewsStand is designed to help people read news via a map. Now, the way to think about NewsStand is the following. Suppose you travel, and if you're traveling, usually like me or anybody else, usually prepare for your trip. So you look up where you're going, and besides, you'd like to know what's happening there. Similarly, you'd like to keep up with what's happening about where you left, especially if it's your hometown. For example, you'd like to know what happened to scores of sports matches, zoning events, or really any other local events. So what NewsStand does, it helps you do this by giving you two options, namely answering the following questions. Given a feature, where is it happening? And given a location, what's happening there? Now, let us look at the question, where is topic Y happening? All right, so here on the left, we see various features, or really topics, ordered by the importance. Namely, NewsStand works with like 8,000 news feeds. So here the top story that we have is really the Nobel Prize winners being, you know, a U.S. person. And now another entry here is Australian, because this person is also an Australian. And if we go another location here is Swedish for Sweden. Notice it's an adjective. Now other events here, we can go down here scrolling. And here's another one about David Letterman, the gift that keeps on giving. And here we see New York, as obviously the event happened here. Now another location here is Manhattan, which is also quite relevant to the story. And then to our surprise, we find Connecticut. This is where our hapless producer went to try to cash his check. Obviously, you know, he didn't get it. Now let's look at some more stories here. And you can see as we scroll down, we get more information. Now here we have, for example, the important typhoon, namely Typhoon Parma. Okay, we see this is an important story. And you can see right here, what are the locations? Namely, the first one is Manila. Another important one is in Vietnam. And we see Vietnam here. Then we see Cambodia. And finally, we see Laos here. And what have we done here? What we've done is we've actually derived information based on, you know, sort of like knowledge discovery. Now, let's move on here. And one of the things we have is we're able to see images. Now, these images are those that are associated with the myriad stories about this tragedy. And the images tell us a lot. They really point out the immense tragedy that's going on through the pictures. Now, these pictures were not collected by saying, this is about Laos, this is about Cambodia. Rather, they were done automatically as they are associated with these stories. Now, these stories are all clustered or really about a similar topic. And we really add another dimension to this tragedy. Now, we can also see here videos. As you can see right here, there's several videos associated with this topic. One is from CBS, one is from CNN, and you can see right here, here's our correspondent, and having seen this, now let's look at another important story, namely the baseball series between the Twins and the Tigers. Notice that the Tigers are being placed in Detroit, which is, there's no word Detroit here, yet we associate with Detroit. The Twins are being placed with Minneapolis, okay? And then if we look at another city here, look at this, the White Sox, they're being associated with Chicago. This is all done automatically. Kansas City, of course, is in Kansas City here. So what we've seen is the power of the system to actually understand location and concepts. Now we're looking at the second type of query, namely, given a location, we'd like to know what's happening there. And here we can see we're zooming in. One of the interesting things is as we zoom in, we can also vary the number of markers that are present. So here we're raising them, and you get more and more markers. Yeah, the number can be rather high. So let's stop right here. Okay, so now let's see what's happening in the Middle East. We can focus in easily like this, just restrict ourselves to this area. And what we see here are some interesting stories. Here we have one at Syria. Notice that the map is focused in on Israel, on the Middle East, Yet this mini-map provides you information about other locations that are relevant to that particular topic, which cannot be seen on the map since there was no space. However, the mini-map gives you a feel for that area. Now, we can also use the mini-map as a way of navigating to other areas on the map to see what's going on there. And here, we've gone into the California, and let's look at Los Angeles area, as we're doing right here. And you can see there's quite a lot of stories here. As we focus in, we can see here's an article about Studio City. We get quite narrow into locations. Torrance, I'm going to zoom in even further in this in the Simi Valley area. And you can see some stories here. Notice here, Chatsworth, this is Moore Park. And we can have other things here as other places, San Fernando Valley. And here is about Studio City again. Let's go here in the Santa Clarita area. And we have other stories in this area as well. Here's about Santa Clarita. Here's about Devonshire. And again, we have Chatsworth. And here, interestingly enough, notice North Hills. And here we have Langdon Elementary School. Would you believe being so precise? NewsStand has much information about various places, including, you know, schools, sports teams, and is quite a surprising thing. You would not think that you could see something this with this precision. Which brings us to one of the strong points of NewsStand, namely, as newspapers are facing economic hard times, local coverage is suffering. Yet what we're able to do is gather information from various sources and show them on the map. Therefore, local news is still happening. And again, this is just being recorded by having a lot of information around and classifying it based on type and associating with geographic location. For more information about NewsStand, you should see other publications by our group. I'm Professor Hanan Samet at the University of Maryland, and I and my staff, primarily of Jagan Sankaranarayanan, Mike Lieberman, Ben Teitler, and Alan Jockaway, and John Sperling, who has helped us being as an initiator of much of this work, have all worked together on this to bring this to you. If you have any more questions, please feel free to contact me.